Welcome to installment number 216 of the mitzvahs as enumerated by Maimonides, the Rambam. For the last few days, we have been discussing the various bodily emissions that renders a person impure. Yesterday, we spoke about a zava, a woman who has abnormal bleeding, meaning bleeding that occurs outside of her regular menstrual cycle. Today, we have positive commandment 104, which talks about a zav, which is the male version of a zava. And Maimonides explains that just as a zava has an emission, an irregular emission from her reproductive organ, so too the male version of a zav is also an irregular emission from his reproductive organ as well. And this is an emission that just comes out of the blue. It is involuntary and it has absolutely no sensation. He doesn't even know that it's happening. Now, the first time this happens, he is not rendered impure. The second time he is rendered impure, however, the third time he is not only rendered impure, however, he must wait 7 days. In addition, he must immerse into a mikvah as well, just as the woman does. However, with the male, it's actually a bit more serious. And as opposed to a woman who immerses in a mikvah, the male must immerse in an actual natural spring, mayim chayim, in natural water, because his emission is considered to be more serious than the woman's, because the woman's can almost be attributed to natural circumstance. It's so similar to her natural menstruation. It just happens outside of that time. However, for the male, it is completely out of the ordinary, completely abnormal, and signals something really serious going on. And we are taught that, you know, a soul comes down onto this earth with a mission, with a job. It is put into a physical body to accomplish a particular mission. And what happens is it comes into this world and it gets comfortable and it starts enjoying all the physical pleasures of life, which is wonderful to enjoy the physical pleasures of life. However, the question is how much of an emphasis we are putting on the physical pleasures as opposed to the spirituality in our lives. And we are told that once a person indulges too much in this excess of the physicality on this earth, then it affects him not only spiritually, but it affects him in his physical as well. And that the cavities in his body that are meant to be clear and open actually get filled with fluid and filled in this sense where he turns into a zava, that what should have been a clear passage ends up being filled with excess, with fluid. And this is really just a message to us to always remember that while it's so wonderful to enjoy the physicality of this earth, we have to remember that we have this physical earth for a specific purpose. We are here to turn it into a spiritual oasis. We are here to turn it into a home for God. And so long that we forget the plot and we end up just indulging too much and making it about us and making it about the pleasures that we consume, then we have lost our way. And unfortunately, we should hope that we shouldn't have to get the message in this kind of way, but rather we should be able to have that wake-up call and notice before we need any unpleasant reminders. Have a wonderful day.